Hi everyone, and welcome to this tutorial bite for Oxygen Not Included, which is about Gravitas. I'm going to cover the game lore and the old buildings found on the map. Although the game has very little story, these could be considered spoilers, so be warned. The lore of the game is found through inspecting old buildings and artifacts around the map. Note that inspecting these in the Spaced Out DLC will drop a databank for research. You can read through all the entries you've discovered in the database here. These are independent of save file and remain unlocked once found. These old messages don't tell a clear story, but give clues into past events. Gravitas was an advanced science organization, including research in bioengineering, as shown by their logo, the DNA strand. The dupes are a direct result of this work, and the company also had interest in the temporal tear, which I'll touch on later. As can be seen in the sky, the Earth was destroyed by an unknown cataclysmic event, and Gravitas may well have been involved. Now, having gone quickly through the lore, I'm going to go through the things they left behind. And I'm starting with the decorative buildings that can't be interacted with, including the Gravitas reception here, which is always at the top of the map in the base game. Everything here is simply decorative and non-functional, and can be deconstructed for small amounts of resources. This applies to most of the buildings found, and I'm also showing some examples here. But the interesting buildings are the active ones that have interactions. And I'm going to start with the printing pod. Of course, this is where dupes learn their skills, and new dupes can be printed every 3 cycles. Care packages can also be taken if enabled, and these give fixed amounts of resources. Note that many resources have requirements in terms of minimum cycles, and if already discovered, but this varies between the base game and the Spaced Out DLC. For the complete list, I've included the link to the wiki page in the description. In the Spaced Out DLC, there are mini printing pods that can be placed at 1 per planetoid. These give the same functionality as the main printing pod, and a dupe or care package print can be taken at any one of these. And next up is the anti-entropy thermonullifier, which is found buried in frozen biomes. This cools down the surrounding area when supplied with hydrogen, and I explained this as part of the tutorial bite for cooling, linked in the card. The other buildings in the base game are often found in hidden areas that must be opened with a bioscan. Once you know what to look for, you can see what's in these rooms even before opening them. You cannot dig or deconstruct a way into these hidden rooms, and the door must be opened first. Make sure there is a tile for the dupe to stand on, and note that they have a direction. These rooms can sometimes be partially revealed, and if so, then simply use the move command to get a dupe close to the hidden area. Inside, these are mostly decorative buildings, but also neural vacillators, lockers, and vending machines. The lockers and vending machines can be rummaged, vending machines drop nutrient bars, and lockers will drop clothing, either a snazzy suit, cool vest, or warm sweater. Neural vaccinators give a dupe one of 4 buffs when used. To do so, assign the dupe here and remember to manually complete the process. The 4 buffs are Regenerative, Deep Diver's Lungs, Sunny Disposition, and Beefsteak. They are all useful, and dupes cannot get the same buff twice. Note that Deep Diver's Lungs does stack with Diver's Lungs. Vaccinator recharges must be returned from space missions to use them again. In the base game, these are found randomly when sending research modules to destinations with available discoverables. In the Spaced Out DLC, they are found randomly from cleaning artifacts in the Artifact Analysis Station. Artifacts themselves are found in limited numbers on each planetoid, and can be gathered from space points of interest. And with that, I'm now going to run through the other buildings in the Spaced Out DLC. Here, there are specific Gravitas buildings added to work with the multiple planetoids. Firstly, there is now a teleporter transmitter and receiver, matched by another pair on another inner planetoid. Simply choose a dupe to send, then once in, hit teleport. The transmitter takes 5 cycles to recharge, and the transmitter on the second planetoid will be ready when the first dupe is sent through, so they can be brought back at any time. On this second planetoid, There is another Gravitas building, this being the Cryotank 3000. Inside is a frozen dupe that can be woken up, giving both it and the activating dupe a morale and stress relief bonus for 10 cycles. The last pair of buildings added to the Spaced Out DLC is the Supply Teleporter Input and Output. These are found on the home planetoid and the same second planetoid as the dupe teleporter. Both sides need to be activated by a dupe with the Field Research skill to send materials. Once done, gases, liquids and solids can be shipped using pipes and conveyor rails. They will then be output on the other planetoid's Supply Teleporter Output. Of course, this is an easy way to transfer materials, but is limited by the pipe and rail capacity. The final point of interest to mention is the temporal tear, and this can be considered one of the end goals of the game. In the base game, this is found at the end of the star map, and will require liquid hydrogen and oxygen to reach. When a rocket reaches this location, it disappears forever with its crew, and the achievement is granted. In the Spaced Out DLC, the tear is found as a space point of interest, and any rocket with enough range can be sent to it. But first it must be unlocked using the temporal tear opener found on the outer frozen planetoid. This requires you to have activated printing pods on 5 planetoids, and it needs direct line of sight to space, 3 tiles wide. A total of 10,000 rad boxes is needed to unlock it, which then gives the option when selected. Beware that doing this will start periodic meteor showers on this planetoid, so prepare with bunker doors and tiles appropriately. Then, the temporal tear will show us open in the star map. And that's it for this look at Gravitas in Oxygen Not Included. I hope this was interesting, and thanks for watching.